Former Trump White House Communications Director Anthony Scaramucci said following the first debate, well, only debate technically, between Donald Trump and Kamala Harris, that Trump would absolutely be calling for a rematch almost immediately. And then, of course, as we all know, Donald Trump came out and said, there will be no third debate, even though CNN has offered. I mean, technically Fox News has offered, and Trump was a little warm to that, but still didn't do it. So, no more debates. And Anthony Scaramucci this week, who again was a former advisor to Donald Trump during his administration, albeit for, you know, a handful of days. Nevertheless, Scaramucci got on social media and said this. I have to confess that I got this wrong about Trump. I thought it was a ruse that he didn't want a debate by President Harris, but it appears that he's actually lost his fighting spirit. There is something wrong. Not exactly sure what it is. Now, Scaramucci is correct. There does appear to be something wrong with Donald Trump, and millions of Americans agree with that. Like, yeah, there's something wrong with the guy. But Scaramucci isn't just saying like, hey, there's something wrong with him. He's actually being a bit more nuanced, right? The fighting spirit part is what's gone from Donald Trump. And that's what Scaramucci is pointing out here. Back in 2016 and 2020, Donald Trump was holding multiple rallies a day at this point, traveling all over the country, just nonstop doing things, even during the pandemic. And he had energy. He was excited. It seemed like he was happy to be wherever it was that he was. And he wasn't shying away from debates, although technically he did. Let's not forget that in 2020, he didn't do the second debate, right? He chickened out of it after Biden beat the tar out of him in the first debate, chickened out of the second, got mad that Biden did a town hall on national TV, and then he came back and did another. So it's not, you know, unusual, I guess, for Donald Trump to back out of debates. But what is unusual is him not having that fighting spirit that Scaramucci is talking about here. So something has happened. And Scaramucci, again, says he doesn't know what it is. So for that, let's analyze things. Donald Trump is obviously 4 years older than he was when he ran in 2020. And he's 8 years older than he was in 2016. So he originally was running when he was 69 years old is when he started. And now he's 78. That's a big jump. You know, if you yourself have gone from age 69 to 78, or if you know somebody, you know, your parents or grandparents, whatever, there's a big jump between the ages of, you know, 70 and 78. And Donald Trump could be experiencing that jump. It could be that he physically cannot do this anymore. You know, when he does his rallies, which of course are few and far between at this point, most of the time he acts like he doesn't even want to be there. He doesn't even care what he's having to say. And yes, like Kamala Harris pointed out in that first debate, people are leaving early. It's low energy. It's repetition. It's just nonstop boring. And so people don't want to be a part of it. So it could be that his age has just severely limited him. And let's talk about the elephant in the room. Maybe he's afraid. Maybe he doesn't like putting himself out there as much anymore after two, you know, potential assassination attempts. For that, I couldn't fault him. But that also does not explain, when he's in these closed door events that are still televised or filmed, why he is such low energy. So maybe he's afraid to hold more rallies because of the attempts. That could explain part of it, but it doesn't explain why he doesn't want to do another debate. It doesn't explain why he can't muster any energy when he's speaking to anyone. And, you know, so it could be, but it's probably not. And there's also the mental factor. We have watched in real time over the years as Donald Trump's mental faculties have been visibly declining. So along with the age and just physically not being able to do it, he may mentally not be able to do it anymore. He may just be at a point in his life where he just doesn't care, right? I'm here. I don't know where I am today. I don't bother about getting people right, names right, positions right, whatever. I can't think of it. I don't care. So that could be part of it. But another part of it could be the stress that he's under, not just from those attempts on his life, but due to the fact that he knows if he doesn't win this, he could be going to jail. If Donald Trump does not win this year's election, he is definitely going to be sentenced at the end of November. That one may not result in prison time. But also, if he doesn't win, he is going to face that January 6th trial in front of Judge Tanya Chutkan. He is going to face that trial in Georgia. And he will likely still have to face a documents trial in Florida, assuming the appellate court reinstates the case. So all of those things are weighing on his mind, not to mention the penalty that he still has to pay from the New York fraud trial. Yes, they put up the bond, but he's going to have to pay those people back. So all of that stress could be eating away at him to the point where he's not even able to physically do the campaign anymore. I don't know what it is. I think it's a combination of all of those factors. But even if it's one or a few or all, it doesn't matter. The point is, Scaramucci is right. Donald Trump has lost his fighting spirit, and it's absolutely tanking his entire campaign. One of today's video sponsors is 8Sleep. If you're like me, you struggle to not only fall asleep, but you also struggle to stay asleep throughout the night. And the big reason is because the temperature can't seem to stay correct. 8Sleep is revolutionizing the way we sleep with their innovative sleep technology known as the pod. If you add the pod to your current mattress like a fitted sheet, it is automatically going to cool down or warm up each side of your bed. It's been clinically proven to give you up to 1 hour more of quality sleep every night. They've just launched the newest generation of the pod, the Pod 4 Ultra. The standout feature of the Pod 4 Ultra is its exceptional cooling capability. It can cool down each side of the bed to 20 degrees Fahrenheit below room temperature, ensuring you and your partner stay cool even through the hottest nights. There's nothing else like it on the market. Imagine being able to set your bed to the perfect temperature, as low as 55 degrees Fahrenheit, for each stage of your sleep cycle. The pod's autopilot feature makes smart temperature adjustments throughout the night, enhancing your deep and REM sleep. Plus, you can leave your wearables on the nightstand. The Pod 4 Ultra's integrated and imperceptible sensors track your sleep time, sleep phases, RHV, and heart rate with 99% accuracy. And they also tell you how long you snore for and the intensity of your snoring. And best of all, the Pod 4 Ultra can be easily added to any bed. Whether you're an athlete, a business titan, or just someone looking to improve their sleep, the Pod 4 Ultra's cooling technology is an absolute game changer. I have been using 8Sleep for a few weeks, and it has completely changed the quality of my sleep. I can actually sleep all the way through the night, wake up feeling normal again. This product is a life changer, and I mean that sincerely. So head to 8sleep.com/ROF and use the code ROF to get $350 off Pod 4 Ultra. They currently ship to United States, Canada, United Kingdom, Europe, and Australia. Again, that website is 8sleep.com/ROF, and make sure you use the code ROF to get $350 off the Pod 4 Ultra.